Now, firstly, just to kick us off for the evening, we would like John, the father of the bride, just to say a few words, if you may.
Good evening, everybody. Brad, I'd like to welcome you to our family. And I've got a few little tidbits to say about Yana. It's all good. But when I was younger, everybody used to get married on a Saturday, and used to get married during the week. I asked to have a Wednesday off to go surfing up the coast, but as an excuse, I used it. My sister was going to get married on Wednesday, so I had a whole week off. But it was denied, but if I did the same thing now, I could get away with it. Fiona and Brad make a good couple. Brad brings out the best of Fiona. Can you believe it or not? You couldn't get boo out of Fiona when she was younger. And now she's a regular chatbot. Her grandma had a lot of input into her life in the younger days. The preschool teacher thought there was something wrong with her because she didn't talk. And her grandmother spoke in Chinese dialect, but if her teacher spoke in Chinese, she'd know. Fiona, as you've heard, Fiona's name, Fiona Grace Pauline. Fiona means fair and persistent. And at the moment, she's the fairest in the land. And Pauline, Paul means precious, Ling means beautiful. But Fiona was persistent in her younger days. She always had an inquiring mind, but persistently pulled towards the part to see how they worked and wondered how they went together. The ones we assembled together never worked again. Fiona has always been an outdoorsy type of girl. She's always helped me put up the tent. She was selected for the Queensland Academy of Sport for volleyball one day. One day we were looking for her and at the training centre up in Brisbane, and there's a whole group of team members, and when they separated, Fiona was in the middle. She was actually the shortest one of them all. Because she was so short, she didn't get into the team. It's good seeing her grow up and mature. Good seeing her grow up into the lady she's grown up to be, and she making decisions for herself instead of relying on mum and dad. And I see Brad's good at organising things, so Brad can organise Fiona. In the younger days, she thought she was Superwoman. She stood on the lounge and took off, and she was flying, but having difficulty navigating the airspace. She was flying, and there was also a fan there, and she hit the fan while I was going, and went to hospital. She got a scar on her head through it. To you, Brad, I have a quote from the Book of Mysteries. An excellent wife who can find, for her worth is far above jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her. And he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not evil all the days of her life. She is like a merchant ship that brings her food from afar. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with Collingwood and Lions jerseys. Just one more snippet. In the younger days, I was doing something with a high-ace van in the driveway, and Grace, Fiona's older daughter, was in the back, and Fiona was in the front. And for some unknown reason, I didn't have the it in gear, but she pulled the handbrake, let it off, and the van started rolling down the drive, and I had to think really quick. Grace, I grabbed her from the back and just threw her out in the drive, and Fiona got her under my arm and ran away from the van, and the van went sailing down the drive. And Brad, I'm telling you, today Fiona's let the handbrake off.
Spend the night with me, and Fee agreed to come and stay over so that I can relax with a little bit of distractions, have a little laugh, have some pizza, watch Netflix. I'm still not really sure if Fee came because she didn't believe me about the ghost or if she just felt sorry for me. But the point of the story is that Fee accepted me for as I was, and there was and was there for me in a scary time, which I'm forever grateful for. Fee, you lit up my days at uni, and I was always so envious of you turning up with those authentic Malaysian homemade lunches that your mum made. Here I was turning up with tuna and rice, and you would bring lemon chicken, homemade dumplings, and all sorts of delicious meals. Then one day, you started turning up with double service, one pack for me. Thanks, Mona. I was so lucky to have a kind-hearted friend like you. And thank you, Mona, for the delicious food. But in all seriousness, Fee, you've been like a little sister to me that I always hope for. You're the yin to my yang, the ming to my mong. I'm absolutely honoured to be here tonight and to have the chance to toast this beautiful woman who has married Prince Charming. Now, a little bit about Brad. As Fee's best friend, I watched her relationship grow with Brad from its early stages into the beautiful union we are all witnessing here tonight. Brad, I remember meeting you for the first time, and I could tell that you were different from the others.
Different.
You weren't just handsome, charming, and witty, but you were someone who could make Fee truly happy. You accepted Fee exactly as she is and could light her up from the inside. After a matter of months, it was clear that they were in love. So then Fee left me, I mean Brisbane, to make the move to Melbourne in the thick of COVID, to start living a life with her new man, Brad. It was a risky time to move into state, but an exciting time, nevertheless. I truly admire Fee and Brad's grit and determination and love for one another, working through those tricky times and everyday life challenges when you just want to have fun and start your exciting new chapter in a big new city together. I think COVID placed you both in a pressure cooker though, and you weathered some tough times and you came out stronger for it. Over the course of months and then years, I witnessed you both blossom individually into mature, caring people. I could see a beautiful bond that had grown into such a loving relationship. I knew it wouldn't be long before Brad finally got down on one knee, and here I am tonight giving a toast to my best friend at her spectacular wedding where we all celebrated you both for an entire month. So, to the bride and groom, today you start a completely new chapter of your lives. I know you will have challenges, as we all do, but I'm confident you will work through it all together and that you will always have each other's backs. Be protective of this special love you have for one another. Always make time to stop and listen and to communicate honestly and openly. And never be scared to tell one another what you really need. Be patient and never forget to have a laugh about all the little silly things that life throws at us. May you come to know each other and understand each other better with every passing day, and may you never forget why you fell in love. Let's all raise our glasses and have a toast to the beautiful newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Fenton. Woo!
Sort of friendly. So I, for people who don't know, I am Bremy's brother. There's about 12 years, just under 12 years difference between him and I. Look, life was going pretty well for me in 93. Almost a teenager, I had my parents where I wanted them, they were doing what I wanted in the weekend, and then this guy turned up. So, my world went from being and going very well to lots of Barney, lots of bananas and pajamas, lots of Macca's playgrounds, lots of merry-go-rounds, and various other child things. So this couldn't continue. there's any Survivor fans in the room, when they go to tribal council to vote people out, we needed to have that happen within our household. So we had a vote. Look, it wasn't unanimous. He did survive. I don't realize that. So look, time did go on after that, and I did get used to Bradley. Thousands of hours of cricket, thousands of hours of kicking the footy, lots of wee tennis, lots of banter, and he is one of my best mates. So there was some good times in there, plenty of tantrums, plenty of broken windows, and plenty more tantrums. Bradley's got an immense work ethic, and it's something I've been really proud of before, and his first boss is actually here in the room today, and I always sat and thought back when Bradley was working in Food Works when he was 14 years old, because he turned up to work 3 hours before his shift started, so Joe's getting a good deal there. But the best thing was, from Joe's perspective, is if Bradley would finish his 8-hour shift, and then he'd go and spend what he earned through the tittle by buying sandwiches and ice cream. It must be the best employee ever, sure. Many great memories living in Brisbane with Brad, with my wife, Ali, and Julia at the time as the young girls weren't there. And Bradley ultimately lived with us 5-6 nights a week and some really, really fond memories. We built an incredible bond. There was plenty of wee tennis at that time. And again, when Bradley had one of his tantrums, he would end up walking up down the street and I'd have to go and drive him and go and pick him up. You remember that day? You remember the day yesterday? He used to just sit on the brick wall waiting for me. And one night it didn't come, so he ended up walking back. where are we now? I need this intro. Are you good?
Seamless, Steve. Seamless.
I've always admired Brady for who he is. No shame, limited awareness of what is happening, limited awareness of who is in the room. Equally, Brad is who you get. Equally, he's got a very, very strong passion for dancing. And many of you may have been witness to a few of his favourite songs, such as... Another one of his favourites. I'm sexy and I know it. Hopefully we'll get to see a bit of that later on. So look, on the theme of improvement, if any of you have checked your emails recently, Bradley's done that. Bradley did an Excel course 4 weeks ago. Not to Thursdays in a week. And I don't care what you did on Monday, mate. Look, it's been an amazing day, and I think, in all seriousness, it is probably my part to be serious and truly tell you what I do think about my brother. I do love this man. He has got an enormous heart. He cares a lot about other people before himself, and him and I have formed an incredible bond over time. So I luckily have a great brother, but I've also got an incredibly good friend, and a great friend, and someone that I care deeply about. Thank you for a wonderful day. Thank you for attending. Let's have a lot of fun over the next couple of hours. I forgot one part, right. So, there was one little other nugget I had in here, right? So, on the theme of development, so Bradley called me in 2019 and he said, mate, I'm living by myself at the moment, but I can't really do anything. And I said, Brad, what do you mean? He goes, look, changing the light bulb, fixing the lawnmower, fixing the coffee machine, like, what do? And I said, mate, just get in there, get it done, make some mistakes and learn. He goes, okay. He calls me back a couple of months later, he goes, remember that chat we had about sort of development? I said, yeah. He goes, I'm good at everything now. I said, okay, how did you do that? Because I found this girl called Fee. And she can do everything. Yes. I do want to welcome you to the family. I've loved every minute that I've spent with you. Great person, beautiful smile, amazing poker player.
Oh.
Sunglasses and a hoodie, and she'll take all your money. Doesn't support Collingwood. Woo. Good. So welcome to the family, Fee. I've always wanted a sister, and I can't be more proud of it. It's you. Yeah, round of applause for you.
Good one, mate.
All right, we're going to take a break. The dinner is about 3 minutes away, so if you want to drink or what will be served, you can't wait an hour. But don't worry. Yes, couldn't imagine two better people for each other. You sort of match it. You both amazing. You do your own thing. And we love it.
Just made it up, I did.
Yeah! You did it well, I'm not that funny, so it doesn't work.
I saw you triple park to the bar before. So.
Yeah, that's got me. It's stitched me up. But no, we are super honoured to be up here. We're both meant for each other. It's been a beautiful day. You look pretty good today, boy. I'm proud of you. You know what I mean? You boys. So, thank you. We'll get on to a few more stories that are a bit more of a stitch up for Brad. I did want to start with that I actually asked both of them for a set of stories about how they met and what they're up to or stuff like that. Both of them gave me stories, that was great. I even checked this morning with Brad that no one else was using these. No, all good, I'm not using it, blah, blah, blah. Celebrities, every single one of them. He literally just copied and pasted the email, and then I'm going second. I've got nothing on Brad. I'm just making up some stories. So thanks for that, mate. That was a mad detail. So I'll give a little bit of backstory on the fried rice story because it seems like everyone seems to know about it, which I didn't actually realise. So as most people will know, Brad actually lived with myself and my partner for about probably 6 months, maybe 9 months. And Fee was in for probably only three. We were having a baby, so we kicked him out. That was my best excuse anyway, but it was good timing. So we've always heard about Fiona's mum's cook. So always thought I'm gonna go, all right, well, you guys have moved in, you can cook, let's see how you go. Should have said that. Fiona goes, oh, Mum's giving me a fried rice recipe. I'm like, oh, cool, let's have a look. Like, show us how you do it. Oh, Mum just said you do a bit of this, do a bit of that. And, you know, it's just fried rice. It was the worst thing I've ever tried. So we had this, it would have been at least 2 litres, if not probably 4 litres of gluggy, thick, black fried rice. The four of us refused to eat. Well, sorry, the three of us refused to eat. Fiona, only time I think I've ever seen her super stubborn. It's fine. Okay, she's sitting on the couch with the worst look on her face I've ever seen her. While the three of us enjoy KFC. But I like the commitment. And the best part was she had another go the next day. It was better. Thankfully, she admitted after that. It was no good. Threw it in the bin. So that's a bit more sort of background to the fried rice.
Mum has taught me since then, sorry.
Thank God for that, because it couldn't have got any worse. Yeah. I'm actually too scared to get you to read because it was that bad the first time. So I'll pass on to Fire to give you a few more stitch-ups, I think.
Just before we get into it, as Chenega said, a couple of stitch-ups, I just want to make note of Brad's character as a mate. It's hard to put into words. Like, he's a mate that everyone needs, because no matter the time or the day, he's only a phone call away. And he's just, becoming to know Brad in the, blokey environment of a football club, is probably one of the most caring people you ever met in your life. And that's honest truth. So he's probably a really good mate, a best mate to Shags and myself, and Brad can be a mate that is you can rely on him for good times, for bad times. You know, he's a shoulder when you need, but he's also more of a phone when you need as well. So I think his character's understated a little bit because he's generally one of the nicest people I've ever met. But I'll tell you what, that's where it ends. I'll start off with a very light-hearted story. We played golf together probably about a year and a half, 2 years ago, and we're actually lucky to be here tonight. I forget the hole we're playing on. It. When you play golf with Brad, you know, you never play straight. You're left, you're right, even behind sometimes. You know, he's the only golfer I've met where he actually loses ground. Just a big tall giraffe holding a metal stick. This story though, we had a cut, you know, one afternoon, because as you can see, we're both a picture of health and we weren't going to walk. So we hit, there's this one hole at Bundoora Golf Club, and there's a hole with just a massive log to the right of the fairway. And we both teed off, and about probably 20, 30 metres up, Brad says, "Shit, Bob, what's that?" "Mate, just a stick. Don't worry about it, just a stick." And, you know, that'll be known as about 35 degrees out there. But then all of a sudden, this stick started to move towards us. Cut long story short, he absolutely shit himself. We got chased by a brown snake at Bundoora Golf Club. So we're both very lucky to be here today. There's another trip we had on a local footy trip up to Meekup. Let me just say, you don't want to be in the car with Brad for over 3.5 hours. Just, you know, I'll just let your imagination be that. Especially after a night of beer and KFC. But the story I have for you is, never ever bet with Brad. He's a bad punter, just a terrible He reckons he gets tips off everyone, he knows every trainer in Melbourne, he's just, you know, up to date with all his horse racing stuff, and he'll decline this story, he'll say it's wrong, but it's 100% fact. There was about 12 blokes in this house up at Meetung, which is a long way away, and we're watching the races one night, and he said, "Boys, let's all jump in a quaddy." "Yeah, no problem at all, we've got to spice up the night." Anyway, we all put in 20, 30 bucks. He goes, "Boys, you've got to pick 3 horses each per race." Cut long story short, we're on the last leg, we're about to win this quaddy. Race starts, I think we're on 8 or 6. 8 or 6 won the race. Whole house has erupted, absolutely gone up. He put the money on the wrong fucking race. So here we are, 8 legs down, we're about to pocket 20 grand. He looks at the betting slip, "Shit, boys, that's on the wrong race." Have you ever seen 12 adult men almost start crying in a split second? And he'll decline that to the day, but it was the wrong race because we didn't have any money at all. He's a great pun, great pun, great pun.
I've got something for you this weekend.
Probably one of the early times when Shagger and myself met Brad was through footy, and as I said earlier, we had this star recruit come down to footy club. He's 207 metres, can kick it a mile, can take a couple of marks. First game of a practice game one summer's afternoon, you could say, 35 degrees, and we got to play on the Hello Turf up at Assumption College in Kilmore. So if so, you know, around that school, that's pretty prestigious. You know, a lot of players get drafted from Assumption, etc. So anyway, we've all turned up. I'm coaching at this time. Kieran's playing. Brad walks in. "Yeah, good, he's here. Great start." Cut long story short, at the end of the game, he actually dominated the game. Dominated. He kept 1-8. Was it 1-9?
1-9.
Sorry, 1-9 behind us. During the game, I said to President, "President, we're going to pay him what he wants. He's had 10 scoring shots. That's his first game of footy." About a month later, I was talking to Shags, and he goes, "Geez, Brad was good that first game, wasn't he?" I said, "Amazingly good." He goes, "He's bloody hungover." I said, "What are you talking about?" He said, "The night before, he went and had about 30 beers out of the pub." So Yeah, you know, that went down right before the footy club. We're just about to pay this bloke what he wants, and we found out the night before, been on the town, got home at 3 a.m. and said we got 35 beers. But that's just Brad, he just gets the job done, that's what we love.
9-1 if I had just...
Last story, probably a bit of a scary story to be honest. I almost got assaulted by Brad in Bali. If you ever want a reaction from Brad, I'll give you a tip. Sit next to him, put your little teaspoon in hot boiling water for about 2 minutes, and then plant the spoon on your shoulder. Ended up with about 4-degree burns, and I almost lost about 8 teeth. I've never seen a grown man crack the shits like you did that day.
It's a tantrum.
But I'll leave it there, but you know, in all seriousness, you can't fault the bloke, and you know, today's just a reflection of me and Fiona. It's been a great day. I could probably say on their behalf, everyone that they love in this room is obviously here, so I'd be very grateful for everyone to be together at the one time. And I know Brad stressed a lot during the week that they just want everyone at the front. So, you know, once the music starts, start drinking, start doing handstands, and...
You first!
And Brad's locked into doing the worm on the dance floor. Oh. Thanks very much.
Go, guys. Honestly, we've got so many people to thank in the room, so please bear with me. I'll try and get through this as quickly as possible. Fee loves cake, and she wants to eat it pretty quickly, so I'm going to do this quickly. Firstly, I need to thank Kieran and Files, you know, having you guys facilitate our wedding and, you know, be the MCs tonight means so much to Fee and I, and, you know, your communication in the last 2 to 3 months has been fantastic. One thing I took from your story, Foles, was bloody footballer. thank you. to Riverstone, they've been fantastic, the food's been great, the beverages keep coming. So, you know, fantastic view, fantastic venue. So, yeah, a place that we're incredibly blessed to share our special day at. Cal, who's out the back, you know, busting some music. Thank you, mate. Thank you so much, can't wait to see what you do in the next couple of hours, and I will be worming, so I'll just work that I'm worming. The man with the camera, who is with the camera, Mike, you would have been in this wedding anyway, but the fact that you've turned up with your camera and you've been our photographer today means so much to Fiona and I think when we get to look back on our photos and know that you're on the other side of the lens, it's going to mean an incredible amount to Fee, to Fee myself, so thank you. That wasn't actually meant to be a joke, but actually, to get to some beautiful people in the room, Fiona's family, John, Mona, Tina, we're missing some family members in Grace and Lionel who are expecting in the next few weeks, which are terrific, as well as Amar, so Fee's grandma. Your family is a family that's built on compassion, love, support, empathy, and I think those values have come through in Fiona and Spades. So I'm forever indebted to the daughter that you've created. So thank you. To my family, I don't have a big family, so for me, Mum, you know, you've been a massive, obviously a big, massive part of my life. I wouldn't have been here without you. thank you. Nice so much, and if anyone ever says that a mother's intuition isn't right, then I'm going to argue till the cows come home, because 8 years ago when I met Fee, on that night she said, "Can you date my son? Why aren't you dating my son?" Mum, 5 years later I was dating her, and 3.5 years later she's taking our surname. So, Mum, thank you. To our bridal... to our bridal party, our wedding party, you know, Ebony. Sorry, that's the other champagne time. Ebony and Danny, thank you so much for being a massive part of our day. I think everybody would attest that you guys look stunning tonight. Michelle's a bit disappointed that you stole her dress, but that's okay. and we're so excited for what's going to happen for you and Sean in the next few weeks. It means so much that you've been able to come down here and jump on a plane and put yourself through that, so thank you for doing that for us. As soon as we get the call that baby's out, we're up at it and we're going to celebrate that with you, so thank you. Danny, you know, you and Cam, you know, you were the first couple we actually had dinner with in Kookaburra. And the funny thing about that night is we were 27, 26, 27, ordered a bottle of red, and we all got ID checked at a restaurant. So we will not be going back to, what is it, Factory 51 or something? Yeah, we're not going back to that joint. But thank you so much for being here. Having your signatures on our marriage certificate means the absolute world. So thank you. To my side, geez. Okay, so everyone else, I do come from a pretty small family, so Steve, you know, to actually get some nice words out of you, yeah, that's you. to get some nice words out of you before was actually surprising, but I wasn't going to do this, but you really made me look like a fool, so payback's, I ain't got to ask you. So I remember Adam telling me a story about 5 years ago of a tattoo you might have wanted to get when you were 18. And it was a Man United FC on your body.
Oh, what was it?
So you can have the tattoo and I'll have the tattoos. Thank you, you know, we spent so much time with you, Ali, and your three beautiful daughters, Julia, Maddie, Sophie. You know, you mean so much to Fee and I, and you know, we're so grateful that you're a part of our life, so thank you. Michelle, we've known each other for 15 years. We've been friends for 13. For those doing the math, there's a 2-year difference there. Michelle actually bullied me at school for the first time. You guys have such a beautiful relationship, and you know, you've just bought a house. There's so many amazing things happening for you guys, so thank you for being here. And we've got so many other people in the room we need to thank, but if we sat here and did that, then you know, we'd probably be sober and probably talked for so long. And Foles, we had that at your wedding. But you spoke for a very long time, so. Emily, I'm so sorry. But you know, no matter where you've come from, we've got people that have taken the day off work and driven an hour up the freeway. We've got people that have driven across from Adelaide. We've got people from Sydney, Wollongong, Gold Coast, Brisbane, Sunny Coast. So, you know, people have made such a massive effort to be here for us, and we're truly blessed that we're surrounded by incredible and beautiful people. So for us to share our special day, we're so grateful. So thank you so much for being here. I don't know what more to really say. I guess there's probably one other person to thank. That waiter at the back, he's fantastic. Faye, I said it before in our vows, you know, you're a beautiful person who puts others before herself, and it's one of the big qualities I love about you, and you are an incredible human. And the fact that I get to spend the rest of my life with you makes me the most luckiest guy, not only in this room, but in this world. So thank you for being you, and for having me in your world. So, thank you.
You're the prettiest thing that ever did see. feeling very mean. I sit sitting in my home. I was my head just to be alone. Thought that love was just a waste of time. Did someone there change my mind? And I said to her, just call me. Kiss the moon.